I'm Vishal. This is a scene where we have a drapery on which we got a plate and fruits. This scene has been downloaded from 3drender.com. So I just want to demonstrate a simple three-point lighting and light groups. So to start with, I would like to select all this geometry and assign a simple AI standard surface shader. So in that, I would like to take a color which should be somewhat clay color, and then I'm going to use a roughness of 0.4 and amount 0.5 specular weight. So I'm just keeping it a rough clay sort of render. I'll create a new camera, and in camera I'll put a focal length of 100 and then enable resolution gate. And then I'll be selecting the camera here, and I'll lock the camera so that accidental navigation can be avoided. So yeah, I would like to start with creating a camera. So I will take a AI Skydome light and then render the scene, and in attribute editor I reduce the exposure so that the amount of ambient fill would be very less. So the first light I am starting with this is ambient fill. Now I would like to create another light, and I'm going to create an area light here, and then I'm going to choose that light. I'll put it here, and then I would like to reduce the spread value to 0.1 and increase the exposure value there. So I'm just trying to create a hard light, and I'm going to put that light little bit angle like that. So I'm getting a hard light here. I just want that I'm increasing the light intensity to 5.5. I'll select this AI Skydome light and increase the exposure to somewhere to -4 units. I'll create another light, and I'll put that light on the opposite side here, and I'm scaling that light, and I'm rotating this light this side, and I would like to increase the intensity of the light here. So I'll increase the exposure. So that should be the rim light from the back. So I'll reduce the specular contribution of this and increase the exposure so that I get some nice strong rim light there. So I'll be using an intensity of 11, and yeah, that's good to go. So that I've just quickly set up this light, and I'm just trying to get a clay render sort of thing. So I've got a decent look and feel. So what I'll do is I'll select this lights and start naming this lights. So I will be opening the outliner, select the Skydome light, and I'm naming this as ambient fill. This light would be called as a key light, and this one will be called as a rim light. So I'm just looking for the render passes, or in terms of Arnold, it is called AOVs, or called arbitrary output variables. So we got this AOVs here, and here we have built-in AOVs in which we got diffuse, and we got indirect and direct passes. Let's see what these three passes may look like. So for that, I'll be rendering the scene. So if you see diffuse pass, it is a direct light with the indirect lighting also. There is no specular contribution, but direct is only the direct light, there is no indirect lighting contribution, which is this, the indirect lighting or the bounce light. So diffuse is a combination of direct plus indirect put together. But when I say only direct, it's only the direct light and there is no indirect lighting contribution. So what I really want is, I don't want these passes what I've gotten built in, but I want the passes which are exclusively per light basis. So I'll be selecting these three passes here and I'll not use that passes. I'll only use one pass, which is indirect pass. Okay, when I generally do the indirect light, indirect pass, it gives all the indirect lighting of the three lights in one single image. So I want that pass here, and I'll select the ambient light and I'll open the attribute editor here. And here we got this in the visibility section, you got AOV light group. So select the ambient fill. In the light group, I'll just name this as fill, and in the key light section, I'll name this as key, and in the rim light section, I'll name this as rim. And there is a reason why I'm naming this AOV light groups. The reason is I'm going to create a custom attribute called diffuse underscore direct underscore key. Now if you see, there is a naming pattern here. So diffuse direct key, key is the thing which I've given in the naming section of AOE light group. So I'll just create and then check what's really happening here. So I'll render it, and what you will see is the key light, or the light which has been placed in that side, its contribution in the light and shadow render elements, that is only rendered. And I can now select another custom AOV, and again I can go diffuse underscore direct underscore fill, then I'll create another one, diffuse underscore direct underscore rim. I'll also create a specular for the key and the rim. So for that, specular underscore direct underscore specular underscore direct underscore rim. So let's quickly check with the result. So specular key is the specular highlights of the key light, specular rim, and diffuse fill, diffuse key, diffuse rim. So I'll just got all these passes which I can generally comp it and then get the result of. So what I'm going to do now is I'll be choosing the which can give me noiseless renders. That's the first thing I would like to do. And also I'll go to the AOV section and I'm going to select the driver here and just enable this option called merge AOVs, because I'm going to do the batch rendering now and I will render in OpenEXR format, and that OpenEXR format should get the passes in one image itself or merged. If not, I'll get all these AOVs what I have taken will be rendered as separate image files. So this option enabling is very important for me. Then I'll go to the comment section, and then here I'll be choosing the camera which I want to choose, and then make sure that it is a single frame. So once everything has been set up and the passes I've taken, I'll be choosing the render by just getting into the rendering section and then choose render sequence. Just click that render sequence. It is rendering now, so it will take a while to render, and then I'll get back. Okay, so we are now in the nuke, and this is the result what we got from the Maya. So we got the diffuse direct, we got key, we got rim, and we got indirect lighting we got specular key, we got rim, all that passes. So I'll be taking the shuffle node here to separate all these passes. So I'll just start by firstly extracting the pass called fill pass, and then let's name this as diffuse fill, and then I'm going to take another shuffle node and let's name this as diffuse key, and then choose the pass here which should be the diffuse key. I'll be choosing the merge node by pressing M on the keyboard. I'll connect the B, which is the background, A, foreground, and then put the blending mode plus here, or you can even use the screen. Then the next one is diffuse rim, and I'm going to put that here and then choose the diffuse rim there, and I can connect the next input A2 there to get the rim light, so that I've got the three lights here. For the sake of organizing things, I hold control and then nicely put the points there. They are automatically snapping to straight lines while I was moving, and yeah, so I'll select everything here. I select everything here, go to other and choose the backdrop. So I'll just select this backdrop here and name this as diffuse group, and the result comes here. So I'll select this node again and paste it here, then take the shuffle node, and in the shuffle I'm going to name this as specular key, and I choose the specular key here, and then another one is specular rim, and I'm going to choose the specular rim, and as I said, I'm going to put that here, and then choose the merge node by pressing M on the keyboard, connected the background, a foreground, and then so I just choose plus, and then you got key light, rim light added with each other. I select these two things and add a backdrop. I can select the backdrop color to something different. Then choose the merge node, put background, foreground, and then connect it. Blending mode is plus again. So you got the specular highlights, diffuse. But before adding the specular highlight and diffuse, I should also take the information of indirect lighting. So let's put this shuffle node here and connect it there, and then name this as indirect and choose indirect lighting. Choose the merge node by pressing M, connect the background to the previous, and this one here, and choose the blending mode to plus. So that was the diffuse key, fill, and rim. Now this is with the indirect lighting, and then let's connect that here. So that's a quick comp, and this is what the result I've got. With this, we got an advantage of let's say I want to tweak the rim light. I can select the diffuse rim, and just by pressing C, I can bring the color correction, and I can increase the brightness of the rim light, or maybe I can add some tints to it, and even I can do with the key light, I can add some warm color or cool color, something like that, and then get the result. So this is what the control we may have when we extract or render the lights separately for the compositing. So this is what we have got. Thank you.